Bill Corbin and the blessing he had. He doesn't know how fortunate he is to be born in a Christian family, surrounded by a larger Christian family, and by a larger Christian family. One thing I just want to say, I have brain cancer. You know, if you were listening, you know I have brain cancer. Now, my sister Sandra, some of you know her, used to be Sandra Enter, but now Sandra Enter Smith, who I firmly believe she's on high on my suspect list of being an angel. But anyway,
amen.
One of the things that I've had with this brain tumor is what I call tumor humor. So I think it's hilarious. But if you don't think it's all that funny, you know, I'm your brother in Christ. You should laugh anyway, you know what I'm saying? And my angel sister Sandra, a few years ago, she taught me a way. Laughing is not easy for me. I can think it's funny, but it's not easy for me to laugh. You know, and so she taught me a method. She said, really, if you want to not hurt somebody's feelings and laugh, you just got to shake your shoulder. So, I'm going to tell you a horrible joke that my dad used to tell, which is typical of his jokes. It's horrible. He said he came to town and he had a banana sticking out of his ear. And some of his friends said, hey, James, you got a banana sticking out of your ear. He said, I can't hear you. I got a banana sticking out of my ear. Oh, man. Actually, that wasn't the main reason I was coming. In January of 2015, I was diagnosed with, the doctor said I had a mass up there. You know, I'm not even Catholic. anyway, I went ahead and played along. You know, kind of masked up. And so, but anyway, and this is the deadliest kind of cancer, theoretically. It's real aggressive and it can change. And anyway, it's come back. We cut it out, but it's come back now. So I had another MRI on June the 9th to see about it, see what it's doing. But I'll tell you, when the doctor told me I had it, I was a little bit excited. I might get to go see God, go see Jesus very soon. So anyway, and I'll tell you, part of my ministry, I feel like my ministry right now is to help others maybe look at it, cancer, deadly cancer, a little differently. You know, I think a lot, is this all you got, devil? Is this the best you got? And it's not that bad. These last 2 years, in some ways, have been the best years of my life. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. I have felt, I may be the happiest person you'll see today. Literally. The most joyful person. I have been so filled with joy through this ordeal. And I have many times, like a lot of people who say, why me? Why me? I say that. But I'm saying, why me? Why was I the lucky one? You got to do this. Why did you pick me to? Oh, thank you, God. Praise God. And my faith is 10 times stronger than I ever was. With cancer, you're free. You can do anything. It can be stupid. Hey, I got cancer. People call on the phone and say, yes, can you send $100 if I send you an envelope for, you know, this good cause? I said, well, I've been diagnosed with brain cancer. You know, we're saving our money for my funeral. You know, they don't have that on their little cheat sheet of how to Okay, well, how did I say? All right, thanks. It works. You can, it just works. It just frees you up. Literally. Praise God. It's not so bad. Cancer's not so bad. Even if it kills you. I have zero fear of death. Zero. So anyway, I wrote this little poem, and then I put it on my Facebook. I do Facebook. I would love to be friends with any of you guys, so go ahead. For some tumor humor and some more serious thinking. But my mom read it. She said, that's the Psalm of Dennis. So that's why we named it Psalm of Dennis. So I'm going to read it to you now. There's not supposed to be anything funny in here, so don't be doing this. You know what I'm saying? Okay. It was the first month of winter, year 2015, and I first got the news that I might not live through the spring. My brain had a tumor the size of a lion. It was a glioblastoma, the deadliest kind. We decided to remove it at first with a knife, and then would try medicine to prolong my life. Before the operation, on the table I lay, and I prayed to see Jesus by the end of the day. But God's plan was different. The surgery went well. God filled me with joy and a story to tell. An angel, or God, came to me while I laid in that bed, and he filled me with joy at the moment he said, Dennis, your faith is strong and it's true. You really do love me, and I really love you. His arms wrapped around me, I felt his embrace. I actually experienced his deep love and wonderful grace. I've now been awake for more than a year. The joy is still with me. The memory is still dear. So I now spread the message of hope and of cheer, with hopes that some hear it and feel much less fear. As bad as things get or seem to appear, you can always reach Jesus. He is always there. So trust in the Lord with your every breath. With him at your side, don't even fear death.